Yet, of course, in fact, the evidence has come there are no Taliban also there in Iraq. And yet, what he did was bombarded, war against Iraq. Large number of innocent people died. The number lost to terrorist atrocities in New York on the World Trade Center coming down is less than a tenth of the toll in Iraq, that kind of killing. If there's anyone who can be called a terrorist, I said this in an earlier occasion, and I repeat again, if there's anyone who can be called a terrorist, it should be George W. Bush. He has declared a war, and it is not a war according to law. It is an unjust war, and not according to international law. And everyone has a right to protest against that war. Anyone could protest, anyone could condemn that kind of war, be a Hindu, Christian, Muslim, fundamentalist, or otherwise. You have a right to protest. Just because we protest and condemn, we cannot be considered as terrorists. One of the most difficult problems is to define terrorism. See, we talk of terrorists. Where is the definition of terrorism? How do you define terrorism? Tada did not define terrorism. Porta did not define terrorism. Only terrorist acts were defined. And those acts could be even under the Indian Penal Code. They're not different. Murder, killing, decoy thief, using guns, all are under the ordinary law. But at the discretion of the police, they can use it as an act of terrorism under Tada law. If it could be broadly agreed that the deliberate killing of innocent civilians, you find this kind of definition in the dictionary, if it could be agreed that the deliberate killing of innocent civilians is a central element in most definitions of terrorism, then in that event, the worst terrorists of the last century should be the USA for bombings of Hiroshima and Nagasaki, where suffering of large number of innocent people has never been healed even after six decades. Just kill lakhs of people in these two places. So also, the worst violators of the 21st century as it began are the USA and Great Britain. There's not much difference between George W. Bush and Laskhar-e-Taiba. Both believe in killing. Killing helps them. Killing keeps alive the tension in this region. That is what they want. That is their business. So the USA has a business of encouraging killing everywhere. It gives them a market. It gives them a market for supply of arms. So also Laskhar-e-Taiba believe in killing. It gives them a market. So while both seek to wield power, one of course with the superior power of USA, and the other of course trying to build up his own other category of power. So it has become the global war. In this way, I think terrorism becomes a permanent feature of these persons. In other words, the permanent feature of American policy is a global war. It will never come to an end. As long as the fear of terrorism is there, they're happy. As a result of this, what is happening in the rest of the world is that freedom and liberty gets curtailed. We are now gradually sliding into what is called a security society. Today, as you must have seen as you walked in, what happened to all of us? Everyone had to have a checkup. Security, internal security. So we are going into a security society. Security is more important, not liberty. Your security. Other you must have read in the paper what is called Advanced Passenger Information System. You get into a plane in London. Within 15 minutes, your full history is sent to Bombay or whichever the destination. When you land there, the police are there. Police know your full history. You've gone to Dubai half a dozen times. Okay, that is enough. They could do anything they like. For example, what happened in Amsterdam, you see, you all know. They saw some people behaving in the plane, people behaving in a very suspicious way. Their appearance, their dress, their speaking language, looking like Arabs, looking at watch frequently, bearded Muslims, and burqa-clad women. Okay, all these are suspicious character, this kind of thing. So security becomes more important. And this is a kind of policing that goes on. And as a result of that, we have all sorts of things that go on in this country, everywhere, because under security society, the police can do anything they like. Other day, you must have read the Antap Hill. Somebody was found in a building which was supposed to have been neglected. Nobody was there. What happened was, the police suddenly found he was a Pakistani, they said. One doesn't know. They went and shot him, killed him. Nobody, no proof, nothing of the kind. So because the neighbor security, the society accepted. Society did not protest. Who was killed? Nobody knows. So the police again believe in this guy because that helps them. They don't have to prove a case. They can detain anyone, keep him inside the police station, days together, without a charge, without anything, in the name of investigation. In fact, the other day, I went to the minority commission. What happened was, people are just being rounded up and taken to the police station. What is the law? If you are taken to the police station, if you are a witness, of course, your statement has to be recorded, and then you have to go home. If you are not a witness, you are a suspect, then your name should be there somewhere. Your name should be in the FIR, or they should have advanced information. But they just can't take you to the police station and say, you are a suspect, you don't know anything about me, but you are a suspect. You keep me, you torture me inside. You keep me for days together. No station diary entry, no report. And one fine day, you handcuff that man with another unknown person who is supposed to come from Pakistan. And they say, you are connected with this two together. This is the kind of system. So in the name of security today, police can do whatever they like. Anyone can be killed in an encounter, deaths, and no investigation. In the name of security, every movement of yours can be tracked. Your bank accounts, for example, your transactions, all come under the check. In the name of security, see, the other day the rule has come. In Bombay city, you can't sell or buy property. You can't rent out your house. You want to rent out, you have to go and inform the police officer. So the police have to be informed. So liberty is becoming a casualty. You are literally going to be enslaved. Soon, if this kind is encouraged, ultimately, you slowly, your rights are being taken away. Your liberty is being taken away. You are enslaved. This is a kind of thing. And I tell you, this is not something new. When TARA was introduced, also introduced for the sake of security, even the Supreme Court, though it's a draconian law, unjust law, after Manaka Gandhi's case, nobody could have upheld that kind of law. Yet the Supreme Court upheld that law. Again, in the name of internal security. In the name of security, that is the main consideration. They upheld FOTA law, again in the name of security. They upheld Armed Forces Special Powers Act, which has had havoc in northeastern state, Manipur and so on, those places. Yet we upheld the law in the name of security. All of principles of the liberal society, justice, social, economic, everything, all those they have forgotten. This is a kind of approach. So this is, therefore, it is necessary, we must understand, this violence must come to an end. So what is the solution? Solution is not arms. Solution is not violence. Violence against what, be it from the people or from the state, no. What is required is that, why should there be so much violence in the society? Our approach should be, why there is this kind of terrorism? What is the reason for that? That is the thing the government must understand. Not arms, not kind of this kind of harsh law. I tell you, there is so much of injustice in the society. Go to any part of India, anywhere. So much of injustice. The rich and the powerful can get away with impunity. Nothing happens to them. America can invade any country, nothing happens to them internationally. Within India, the rich and powerful are not bothered. They don't go in for voting, but they get whatever they want. But the poor, what happens to the poor? The marginalized. Huge projects, for example. We have built huge projects. I got details of statistics if you want, I can give them. What happens to them? Narmada Dam is the simplest example. Came up. What happened to the people who are affected? Large number of tribals, what happened to them? They had lost their land.